So I'm at the Clearwater Falls. It's a campground and it's a day use area in the Umpqua National Forest. I hope I'm mispronouncing that incorrectly. The water is incredibly clear. It's really pretty here. It's definitely worth going in to check out the falls. So let's go for a hike. This is the Spookastic Stranger. I'm going. Come on with me. Let's go for a walk. The water in this river is remarkably clear. And I imagine it's also remarkably cold. It's not exactly the warmest of days right now. I wouldn't want to step in that. Foot might come out like an ice cube. So I'm going to zoom in here at these falls, see if I can get a better view from back here. There's a little bridge that goes along the this river, or across it. I couldn't do much talking in the other video. I didn't really do any because the falls are just way too noisy. But I wanted to get a good shot of just how clear this water is. You can see all the way to the bottom. It isn't that deep, but it's probably about a good 3 feet deep, I would guess. So this is Clearwater Falls. There's a campground and there's a picnic and viewing area of the falls. This sign is a little bit deceiving. There is room in here for an RV to pull in. It's limited, and if you're towing a trailer, unless it's really small like mine, you probably need to back in. There actually is just a very limited area here. But there's a road that goes on from it that you kind of think may lead to a larger area. It doesn't. There is a spot that I could have turned around in, possibly. But I didn't want to go down there, so I backed out. But a larger trailer would have a really hard time. Do not go past where I am parked at all. And don't go down the other way unless you want to go through the campground, because once you get to the parking area, there's no place to turn around in a larger vehicle. But it's a pretty spot. It was worth the stop. It was definitely worth the walk to the falls. Glad I did it. A lot of really big trees in here. I believe some of these are cedars too, which is a nice change from all the pines and fir and spruce that I've been seeing. I believe these are red cedar. Pretty big, 3 foot, 4 foot in diameter, tall. This one I'm parked next to has got to be at least 80 feet. Well, that's it. I'll see if there's anything else to film. So I kind of broke my own rule of always walking in an area that's questionable. I definitely would not recommend going down here towing a trailer larger than mine. It does fork, but it dead ends shortly after this. I backed out of here. It was easier. I figured I had less chance of getting stuck in there if I backed out, which wasn't a big deal. But you better be able to back up a trailer. I would not come in here a second time. But just to give a little bit of an idea how big the trees look here. That's pretty big.